Starting today, they're actually selling rice at 42 pesos per kilo in Kadiwa stores. That's down from 43 pesos. And DA Secretary Francisco Tularell Jr. was saying, you know, this could have been, the reduction could have been bigger if only the peso did not appreciate so much from 48 to 58. Just this year. But they're saying, you know, the price could actually still go down depending on how rice prices in the world move, plus, of course, the forex. And, of course, this is a result primarily, mainly, of the cut in the rice import tariffs. Almost 9 in 10 flight arrivals at Manila's main gateway were on time during the recent UNDAS break. The new NAIA Infrastructure Corporation reports a nearly 88% on-time performance for arriving flights, exceeding the industry standard of 80%. However, departure performance was lower at just over 75% due to baggage handling issues. The airport also saw a four-year high of over 930,000 passengers and 5,600 flights during the peak period. Looking ahead, the operator plans to provide real-time updates on flight and baggage delays through the airport's public address system. Monthly performance reports will also be published with system upgrades in the works. The NNIC, a consortium led by Ramon Ang San Miguel Corporation, took over NAIA operations in September of this year. Another U.S. trade mission led by U.S. Commerce Undersecretary Marissa Lago is now in the Philippines to push for investments in digitalization. One contract signed is for a biometric system for Philippine airports. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
U.S. Commerce Undersecretary for International Trade Marissa Lago is in the Philippines for the U.S. first ever Smart Cities Trade Mission. This follows the high-level trade mission by Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo early this year, which gained over $1 billion worth of investments for the Philippines. Lago says her trip solidifies further the U.S.'s strong ties with the Philippines.
The Philippines becomes the only country in the world that in 2024 will have two high-level trade missions. I think that that is a testament to the strength and the potential for even further growth of our relationship.
The Smart Cities Trade Mission will bring in a dozen American tech companies and will visit Manila and Clark in the Philippines, as well as Jakarta and Denpasar in Indonesia.
These companies represent a broad swath of sectors: cybersecurity, artificial intelligence, biometrics, engineering and construction, and particularly important as I sit next to the Secretary of Transportation, Rail.
One of the delegates, UltraPass ID, has signed a memorandum of agreement with the Philippine Department of Transportation to bring a biometric system to Philippine airports on a trial period of about 6 months. Philippine Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says the pilot airport will be Iloilo International Airport.
The biometric system provides not only convenient passenger processing, but also enhances security protocols. Embedded biometric data in passports will allow passengers to breeze through check-in, security, and boarding gates.
UltraPass ID is an American company specializing in biometrics and digital identity. This will be their first foray into airport operations. Its CEO says their platform is linked to airline systems as well as the Philippine ID system.
UltraPass's technology integrates seamlessly with the Philippine national ID system. And through the pilot, we will showcase how digital identity verification can reduce processing time, improve security, and create a touchless, efficient airport experience. In order to be touchless, essentially you're going to be using your face instead of having to show your boarding pass.
The agreement will cover only a few months and will be of no charge to the government. And if it becomes successful, Bautista says they may consider expanding the contract.
Kailangan makita natin yung it will really result to a better travel experience for the passengers. No? Kasi ang objective niyan is maging mabilis yung processing ng mga papers, and that's why we will use yung information doon sa national ID.
Lago, meanwhile, will tour New Clark City and check on the Luzon Economic Corridor, a project of the Philippines, U.S., and Japan. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Telecom giant Converge ICT sees its net income increase by 29% to 8.2 billion pesos in the first 9 months of the year, while consolidated revenues stood at 29.9 billion. That's higher by 14% on an annualized basis. Converge CEO Dennis Uy attributes the increase to strong performance in the company's residential, enterprise, and wholesale businesses. Converge also reports it will spend around 11 to 13 billion pesos in capex for the year. That is lower than its initial plan of 15 to 17 billion. That's as bad weather delayed some of its port rollouts and expansion activities.
We are happy and progress we make both financially and operationally. We believe this is the fourth year of after pandemic. We have here on our reputation as an innovator in the fixed broadband industry. And more Filipino are realizing our competitive advantage. All our efforts are close to anchor to our vision, which is empower the Filipino nation. We also aim to give our consumer fully full and amazing digital experience.
The Philippine Central Bank vows additional measures to encourage more Filipinos to adopt digital payment methods. According to the BSP, affordability, lack of trust, and limited awareness are key factors still holding many Filipinos back from using digital payments. In 2023, digital payments accounted for 52.8% of retail transactions.
We do a quarterly consumer expectation survey. And we have these rider questions there in that survey. And one of the questions there is, what's keeping you from using digital payment? First is the lack of identity document, but that's declining because of the, you know, 57 million plastic IDs already out there.
The KYC
and
is
the
such a big issue.
And pushing 90 million digital IDs out there. So that's declining. The second one is like, you're right, the trust and awareness issue. And the third one is affordability, which I understand because you use a tricycle, you pay by digital, the tricycle costs 13 pesos, but you pay 15 pesos for the fee.